Hello, wonderful person. This is Anton, and in this video, we're going to take a look at much larger picture and try to understand what a local group of galaxies represents. We're going to basically leave our own galaxy, the Milky Way, and take a look at our neighbors. Welcome to What the Math. So it's actually not very easy to try to imagine all of this because of the scale and because of the distances involved. This right here is obviously our own galaxy, the Milky Way, and even right now I'm already at a distance of several thousand light years away from our planet Earth. As a matter of fact, finding planet Earth here is going to be very, very challenging. You may want to take a look at one of the previous videos when I actually forced myself to try to do this completely by visual cues. But today we're not doing this. Today we're actually taking a look at our neighbors. So right here, I'm going to actually point out some of the more obvious neighbors, and we're actually going to pan around our galaxy just until you see some of the more obvious galaxies next to us. And if you look at the bottom, you'll see the first two very well-known galaxies, the Large Magellanic and the Small Magellanic Clouds. These galaxies are approximately 130 to 150,000 light years away from us, and these are basically some of our nearest neighbors. But this is far from what we would call the local group, also known as the local neighborhood. As a matter of fact, there are actually 54 galaxies that we consider to be neighboring our Milky Way. In other words, if we were to actually take a look at all of our neighbors, we would discover three large galaxies and approximately 51 smaller ones. Some medium-sized, like the ones you see here, and some are even smaller than this. Now, let's actually first take a look at some of the closest galaxies to us, within about 1 million light years away from our galaxy. And to do this, we're actually going to use this 3D map right here, and I'm going to zoom out of here at a distance of approximately 1 million light years. Or I guess somewhere around here. This is about 1 million. So you'll notice that there's actually already quite a few galaxies next to us, and all of those orange names you see on the screen, all of them are actually individual galaxies. So some of the more well-known are actually close to us, but some of them you may have never even heard of. Like for example, some of these galaxies were actually only discovered less than a decade ago because they were so small and so dim that we didn't even know they were there. But to take a look at the entire local group, we actually have to zoom out a lot more. As a matter of fact, the local group as of today is approximately 10 million light years away from our own galaxy. So that's actually around here. And you'll notice that there is a lot more things going on here. As a matter of fact, it's actually kind of difficult to imagine all of this because our brain is not very good at 3D representation. We don't really have a very good 2D map of this. And the best way to make a 2D map is to actually try to create vertical alignment of each of the galaxies, but this just makes it even more confusing. And so in this sense, it's actually challenging for humans to imagine the local group. Now I'm going to point out some of the more obvious members, and I'm also going to point out some members that are actually not part of this group, because not all of these galaxies are the local group galaxies. So, for example, there is a few of them right here in this region that are actually creating their own local group. Now, how do we know this? Well, that's actually because gravitationally, they're not attached to anything in our region. They're not attached to the Milky Way or to the Andromeda Galaxy. And so they actually have their own sort of way of moving around the universe. And this particular group is sometimes known as the Maffei group after some of the galaxies in this region. And as you can kind of see, even though they do resemble Milky Way in some way and Milky Way's neighborhood, they basically have their own neighborhood, their own neighbors and their own motion. And this is actually just to give you an idea of how complicated things are when it comes to trying to understand galactic motion and galactic relation. Anyway, let's go back to the Milky Way, which is right here. And let's go back to that map to take a look at some of the more obvious members. Now, first of all, I actually wanted to explain to you what overall the shape of this local group is. We actually often refer to this as a binary distribution or a dumbbell distribution because we have these two specific regions where most of the galaxies are concentrated. One region is right here where the Milky Way is, because there's a lot of really tiny galaxies orbiting around the Milky Way, our closest neighbors. But the other one is actually here. This is where the Andromeda galaxy is, but also a lot of other galaxies, including Triangulum, which is actually the third biggest galaxy in the local group. Andromeda is actually right here, and around the Andromeda galaxy, there is quite a lot of tiny dwarf galaxies pretty much all over the place. And as a matter of fact, very recently we discovered a completely new galaxy that was hiding behind all of this, although we're not entirely sure if it belongs to the local group yet. So even though currently the local group is defined as 54 galaxies, it might actually become more or less in the future. And the Andromeda galaxy is the biggest member here, but one day the Andromeda and the Milky Way will combine and create one mega galaxy. There's actually a video I made about this a few years ago, and it does describe this in a lot of detail. Now, unfortunately, for the sake of making this video a little bit shorter, we're not going to go through each galaxy, but we are going to take a look at the types of galaxies in the local group. Now, there is actually three spiral galaxies. There's Andromeda, the Milky Way, and the Triangulum galaxy, which is very, very close to Andromeda, but is also most likely attached to it gravitationally. It's a lot smaller than the Milky Way and it's a lot smaller than Andromeda, but much bigger than all of the other members. This will also most likely collide with the Andromeda and the Milky Way and create the mega galaxy approximately 5 to 6 billion years in the future. Now, there's also a few elliptical galaxies here, although the biggest elliptical galaxy and the one that we actually consider to be the best representative of all of the elliptical galaxies is this. This is M32, also known as NGC 221, and it's one of the bigger elliptical galaxies in the region, but it's actually attached to the Andromeda, so it's technically its satellite. We also have a lot of irregular galaxies. These are galaxies like, for example, this Sextans B, which basically have a very unusual shape, a shape that is very difficult to define. And as a matter of fact, most of the galaxies that are in the local group are sort of like this. They're sort of like blobs of stars and matter and black holes all together. There are also smaller elliptical galaxies, like for example this right here. This is M110, also known as NGC 205, and this is also a satellite of Andromeda and the fifth largest galaxy with the mass of about 9 billion suns. Now, these are also elliptical, but they're much, much smaller in comparison to regular elliptical galaxies, so they have their own type. They're known as DEG, also known as dwarf elliptical galaxy. And sometimes when galaxies are not that elliptical but are more spherical, they're known as dwarf spherical galaxies, DSG. There's actually quite a lot of them all over the local group, and many of the galaxies like this one right here actually get eaten by the larger galaxies like the Milky Way and then end up creating the spiral galaxies like the one you see in the background. That's the Milky Way. As a matter of fact, we think that one of the reasons Milky Way has so many unusual shapes is because it actually swallowed quite a lot of these spherical and elliptical dwarf galaxies. Now, unfortunately, most of the modern maps are just not very good at presenting this visual information. As a matter of fact, this is the best map we currently have of the local group, and it's just very confusing. It's very difficult to identify specific members, and more so, it's just difficult to navigate this. So hopefully one day we'll be able to create a method and a technique to actually create three-dimensional representations of space much better than we currently have right now. As of today, though, this right here, I think, represents one of the better ways of seeing what's out there in our neighborhood around the Milky Way galaxy. So this right here is what we call the local group, but as I mentioned before, some of these galaxies are actually not part of the group. And unfortunately, just based on this map, it's difficult for us to actually see which ones are not. And the biggest reason for why it's impossible for us to tell which members are not part of the group is because we don't really see the motion of these galaxies on these maps. These maps don't show us what is connected to what gravitationally, and that's exactly how we define membership of the local group. So until we're able to visually identify and present all of this information, we're going to be stuck with pretty much this. And although I guess it does work in some sense, trying to identify specific galaxies and then trying to actually find them on this map is going to be quite challenging. Like, for example, a lot of these galaxies are actually not members of the local group, even though they're within 10 million light year radius from the Milky Way. So they establish their own group and thus should not even be on this particular map right now. And although honestly this is actually kind of confusing to look at, what is beautiful about Space Engine is that it actually allows you to eliminate some of these galaxies, specifically the smaller ones, and to then only take a look at the larger galaxies with the most amount of stars. And that way you can actually then start to navigate the systems and try to define the groups of galaxies by the most massive members. So right here we have the Andromeda Triangulum, Large Magellanic Cloud, and the Milky Way. That's the local group of massive galaxies. Then we have another galaxy here that's actually not part of the group, but that's actually in its own group known as the Council of Giants. There's actually 12 of them surrounding our local group. And at the same time, most of these other galaxies that you see on the screen that are not in this area create their own very, very unique and very specific groups as well. And so to me, what this actually means is that our maps are outdated. We need to create a new technology and a new field of study that basically creates three-dimensional maps or even four-dimensional maps, space-time maps, maps that can present four dimensions of space and time that we can then use to navigate the universe. Until then though, we're going to be stuck with these very confusing two-dimensional pictures that are trying to present space in a way we can't really understand. Anyway, so now hopefully you know a little bit more about the local group, and in some of the future videos we're going to talk about our neighbors and also about some of the more unusual galaxies in the region. Thank you for watching, come back tomorrow to learn something else, consider supporting this channel on Patreon because it does help me a lot, and space out, and as always, bye bye.